sand pile.
Hopi house there. All right, we're approaching the Second Mesa. The Hopi Reservation. That mesa extends for quite a ways. Buildings up on top of the mesa. Must be the Hopi village. Man, I can't keep this thing straight. The village, top of the mesa. I don't know. I guess you can get up there. I don't know if we'd have permission to do that. Now, she said we have to go to the left from here.
To the left?
Yeah. Going to the Hopi Cultural Center. Well, we can tune into the Weather Information Center and learn that it's going to be probably in the mid-70s and dry. Drop down into the mid-40s at night. You're going up a mesa, aren't you excited?
Thrilled.
Huh? You're thrilled? Doing the zigzag here. Just a moment. Watch for rocks. See any rocks, Charlotte?
Yeah.
Shungama. Coming down off the mesa. This is beautiful country. I guess it'd be very difficult for an enemy to approach. Miles an hour around a curve. We had to go in town for it?
I don't know. She was telling you something about take a left, take a left.
Formation, huh? Looks like a lot of the rock has been walking out of place there. Look at that big old area right there. In our backyard, it'd probably be a problem. She's made a sculpture.
Warning, sharp curve ahead.
You think? Now, we're in the Navajo Nation now. We're looking out for Navajo scouts on the top of these hills. Smoke signals.
Warning, John Wayne.
Yeah, we don't want John Wayne to get hurt.
No.
Oh, Navajo horses. Sheep.
Yeah.
have to watch out for rattlesnakes.
I'm sure they get used to that.
What? Watching out for rattlesnakes? And know what a rattlesnake looks like?
Yeah, I took a picture of one yesterday. Western rattlesnake.
Yeah, but they hide pretty well.
Shake the grass.
This is Window Rock. I haven't